Hello students, welcome back to the biology class. So in the last class we started the 13th chapter, that is organisms and population. We learned about the definition of ecology in the last class, that it is the branch of biology which deals with the relationship between the organisms of different type as well as the organisms of the same type, that mean within the species and within between different species. We can even call it as the interspecific and intraspecific interactions. And not just the interaction among the living factors, even the interaction of the organisms with their environment is learned under ecology. We learned that the father of ecology worldwide is Theophrastus, who is also the father of botany. And in India, the Indian ecology father is Ramdeo Mishra. We learned that the ecology involves the interaction of individuals of the same species, and then it is called as orticology. And if there is ecology which deals with the study of the interaction of different populations, that means of different species interaction, it is called as synecology. Syn means when we do something together. So we learned in the last class that there is a hierarchy in the biological classification organization. We all know that molecules, biomolecules join to form the subcellular structures which join to form the cells. And then cells maybe of different type or similar type joins to form tissues, and tissues join to form organs, organs join to form organ systems, and then so many organ systems all together give rise to an individual organism. In the same manner, we learned in the last class that hierarchy is there even in the ecological organization. So a single individual organism of a particular species, when all brought together, will give rise to population. We learned population is the number of individuals of same species at a particular time in a particular area. And then in a particular area, there is not just always one species, there are many species of living organism, plants as well as the animals along with the microorganism. So all different populations together is called as community. And then communities of different type interact among themselves along with the environment, and that is called as ecosystem. And ecosystems join to form a big area which is called as a landscape, and landscape joins to form a bigger area which is called as biome. And finally, biomes all brought together is called as the biosphere. We learned that the biosphere has three main portions: the area of the atmosphere where life is possible, area of the lithosphere where life is possible, area of hydrosphere where life is possible. We also learned that environment is the sum total of all the abiotic and biotic factors as well as the conditions that surround and influence the organism. And we learned that environment basically includes the resources which are utilized by the living organism. And then there are certain factors which are called as the regulatory factors, which also are the part of the environment. We learned apart from environment, we also have the concept of weather, climate, then even the microclimate along with the habitat and microhabitat. We learned that climate is a bigger component compared to the weather. Weather changes a lot, but climate remains similar for a long duration of time. And we also learned that apart from the climate, we have a microclimate, because every area will have a sub area where due to certain factors, climatic variation could be there, and that is called as the microclimate. We also learned that habitat is a specific place where certain combinations of factors are there because of which particular plants and animals live there, because they are best adapted there for their survival and reproduce. And in a habitat also, it is possible to have a micro habitat, that would be the smaller portion of habitat where certain different degree of factors would be available, because of which particular type of plants and animals would be found there. We also learned that that there are four climatic zones when we talk about the latitudes: tropical, subtropical, temperate, and the Arctic zones. And we learned that tropical is closer to the equator from 0 to 20. And then there the vegetation basically is the tropical forest without any winters over there. And the subtropicals include 20 to 40 degree north as well as south, where there is a slight amount of or mild type of winters are there. And vegetation there is the subtropical deciduous forests. and then there is temperate zone, which is farther closer to the pole, 40 to 60 degree north as well as south, where occasional amount of snowfall, that means a long duration of winter with occasional snowfall, is there. And there the vegetation possible is mixed coniferous. And then we have the Arctic Antarctic zones just next to the polar region, 60 to 80 degree north as well as south, where a lot of snowfall, that means a very heavy, long and heavy winters are there. And those are the area where Arctic vegetation is available. Similar zones we learned in the last class are even present in the mountains also. So when we talk about mountains, if a mountain is in the tropical region, we learn that it will have tropical, subtropical, temperate and the alpine zone. And if we talk about a mountain which is in the subtropical area, it will have subtropical, temperate and alpine zones. If a mountain is in the temperate region, it will have only temperate and alpine zones. So this is how we learn that the according to the altitude also, you will find similar type of climatic zones are there. We also learned the definition of niche in the last class, which is also called as ecological niche, that it's a part of habitat occupied by the individual of species having its own range of temperature, having its own range of tolerance, plus food, movement, activity, and timing of the activity. So similar organisms can occupy a similar niche, and if they occupy it in the same habitat, it is called they are called as guilds. And if they occupy the similar niche in the different habitats, they are called as ecological equivalents. Each species occupy a distinct niche, and then those organisms which show metamorphosis in their life cycle, they generally carry different types of niches in the different stage of life. We also learned that there are various biomes available, which is given in the NCRT also: tropical, deciduous, coniferous, grassland, desert, Arctic and the alpine tundra. And we learned that sun is the source of light as well as temperature, and radiations fall vertically in the tropical zone, obliquely in the temperate and polar zone, and the seasons change because of rotation of the earth and the tilt of the axis. We also learned about this graphical representation in the last class, that there is mean annual precipitation and mean annual temperature, which is quite variable in different types of biomes. So these are the various biomes. This much we covered in the last class.